this morning. This morning's service, we have myself and Sangye, worship associate will be Sylvia. We've got quite a few singers today and two special musicians backing us up. And again, our shared plate for the entire month of November is the Amamutsen Land Trust. And we'll talk more about that during announcements. Executive Director Sarah French is with us today. We'll talk more about that. And as always, piano accompaniments for this many of the songs from Carol Thorson, and Bryn's always there to help us with the technical. Let us begin our worship together in our traditional way of ringing our singing bowl first. Now I invite you to put your screen on speaker view, and we, Sangye and I, will give all of you welcome words. So I'm going to go off shared screen and do our welcome. Good morning. Thanksgiving is finally here, and I guess that means the holidays are here too. And I wish you a great Thanksgiving Day in whatever form it will come to you this year. I'm Russ Menk, the senior minister serving this wonderful congregation.
And I'm the intern minister, Sangye Hawke, here until June 30th of 2021, delighting and learning and growing with this congregation as I walk in the path of a UU minister. And I also wanted to welcome all of you who have been here for the very first time.
Just a day in history, John F. Kennedy was assassinated today, 57 years ago. That's, for some of us, that's a little hard to comprehend, but yeah, it's a long time. Every Friday, the news report I watch starts off with, quote, "This last week has truly been another week like no other in U.S. history." I'm getting tired of history made every week, especially the kind of history we're currently making. The news I get talks mostly about three areas. One, COVID-19, 254,000 deaths in the United States, new cases approaching 200,000 per day. California just issued a statewide nighttime curfew. The National Guard has been deployed to El Paso to provide support with the morgue crises there. And if you are a Black Indigenous person of color, your hospitalization rate is 4 times that of whites. The second subject the news I get talks about politics, and I won't even go there. The third area of the news that I get is about the economic situation, the dysfunction between the stock market at near high records and people I know who can't pay their rent or afford healthcare. Now, some of you may remember before the pandemic, oh, say 2019, we were talking about climate change. Do you remember? I don't get much news about climate change these days because it's not a new historical event every week. We ought to sustain two areas of focus in our lives, a focus on the immediate so we can survive, and a focus on the long view so our children will survive. When we are overwhelmed with disturbing news about the immediate traumas, we forget and neglect the long view. And we do this at the peril of those who will come after us. Today, we will wrestle with the long view, specifically about the land we live on. It's challenging to focus on the long view when every week of 2020 has brought us truly another week like no other in U.S. history.
If you find that you are having trouble holding gratitude with grief, you can find space for both here.
If you can't stop worrying about all that is happening around you and you feel powerless, you are welcome here.
Know that every step you take, every thought you have, every word you say resonates with the universe, and you are resonating and welcomed here.
If this is the time of year when you reflect on what you're grateful for, and you can always recite a long list of blessings that you've received, you are welcome here.
If you've found hope this week and believe in working together, and that is the best path forward, you are welcome here.
If you know the path forward will be tough and exhausting, but you're willing to keep going and keep trying to do the right thing, you are welcome here.
All of you are welcome here because our most precious resource on this planet is each other.
We gather together each week to try and figure out how to lead a life of purpose and meaning using our values and principles in this very complex world. Like to make sure I'm on mute and sing along. We have a bunch of announcements, and please bear with me. If you are a visitor visiting us for the first, second time, whatever, please put visitor in the chat box so we know you're here, and just can keep tabs on you and make sure you're welcomed. We've started, we being Sangye, myself, and we might get the other two ministers involved, a Vesper service on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. It's a 30-minute spiritual contemplative worship service to give another chance to connect with something worship during this season. And all these links are all in current happenings, and so please read that carefully. Today, after the service, Sarah French, the interim executive director of the Amamutsen Land Trust, will be with us. If you want to hear more about the Amamutsen Land Trust and talk to Sarah, question and answers, when Bryn offers you a breakout room, just stay in the main session and Sarah will talk to us there. Also, our Rev Ryan, Interfaith Ministry, is been asked to speak for a few minutes on the Thanksgiving Eve, a large gathering of interfaith in the Santa Cruz area, gathering with gratitude around the table. And if you want to see that, the links are in current happenings. We, the fellowship, are having a Thanksgiving Day drop-in. It's essentially a no-host gathering where any of you can just drop in, talk, tell a joke, share a recipe, show us what you're eating. That will be on Thanksgiving Day from 4 to 6 p.m. Also, Ryan is starting with one of his cohorts, A Artist Way. If you don't know anything about the book, The Artist Way, this will be a several sessions based on that via Zoom and should promises to be very creative and inspirational. And finally, more details to come, but we are entering a new era of e-giving real time today, where you will be able to give donations like you used to do when the plate was passed. So please stay tuned. I will invite Sylvia to unmute herself so we can hear our chalice lighting.
This is by Leslie Paul Koshbaugh. Flame of the fire, spark of the universe that warmed our ancestral hearth, agent of life and death, symbol of truth and freedom, we strive to understand ourselves and our earthly home.
Now time for our land acknowledgement.
The land on which we are gathered is the unceded territory of the Awawa-speaking Upi tribe. The Amamutsun tribal band comprise the descendants of indigenous people taken to the missions of Santa Cruz and San Juan Bautista during Spanish colonization of the Central Coast. That group is working today to restore traditional stewardship practices on these lands and to heal from the historical trauma. We remember their connection to this region and give thanks for the opportunity to live, work, learn, and pray on their traditional homelands. Let us take a moment to pay respect to their elders and to all Indigenous people, past and present. Even during sheltering in place of the pandemic, some members are staying connected by sharing their time and talent to build and strengthen our community. We recognize and celebrate these volunteers during our virtual services to lift up the extraordinary efforts by a member to keep us connected. Today, we will be celebrating the dedication of Dee Takamoto and her work with the memoir writing classes that she's been organizing and facilitating since August. Jan Miracle will now share a highlight of Dee's work. Jan, if you would unmute yourself.
Yes. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Dee. The memoir class meets on the first Saturday of the month, and how we look forward to those meetings. Dee has provided us with guidance, support, and encouragement in our writing. She gives us suggestions on enhancing and bringing out the color in what we write. We've learned that the more we remember, the more we remember as each memory stimulates another. We actually get a new insight into our lives. And in sharing, we are amazed at the differences in our life stories. We've grown to know both ourselves and one another better. We thoroughly enjoyed our time together and look forward to it every month. Dee, thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And it continues. Dee, if you're out there, if you would like to unmute yourself and say something, you are welcome to at this point.
Thank you very much for that wonderful comment, Jan. I want to invite everybody to come to the memoir class. I always get comments from people saying, oh, my life was too boring and so on. And I got to tell you, some of these people had the most exciting lives. It's been so much fun sharing their stuff. Some of it was fairly naughty. And as kids, they really got into interesting things. And it's been, I think, really enriching for all of us to get to know each other and to go back through our lives. It's a way to reassess your life and look at what happened to you. And the group has been a wonderful giving and sharing experience for me as well. Thank you, everyone in the class. And I welcome everyone. It's a drop-in class. You can come anytime you want. Thank you.
And the link to that is in Current Happenings. If any of our visitors don't want it, please contact me at our website, uufscc.org. Emails are there. Our administrator, Pamela Sandell, also has all the links. Or if you know someone in the congregation, they can get it to you. So we want you all to be able to stay connected.
The fire, the water, the air, return, 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 return. The earth, the fire, the water, the air, return, 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 return. Away, 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 return. Oh, 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 oh. Away, 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 oh, 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 oh. The earth, the fire, the water, the air, return, 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 return. The earth, the fire, the water, the air, return, 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 return. Away, 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 oh, 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 oh. Away, 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 oh, 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 oh. The earth, the fire, the water, the air, return, 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 return. The earth, the fire, the water, the air, return, 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 return. Away, 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 oh, 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 oh. Away, 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 oh, 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 oh. The earth, the fire, the water, the air, return, 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 return. The earth, the fire, the water, the air, return, 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 return. Away, 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 oh, 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 oh. Away, 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 oh, 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 oh.
We're beginning to reintroduce the story for all ages, not because, or for the children, because it is a story for all ages. And now a short video about gratitude.
Thank you.
in November. As I mentioned, our shared plate collection will support the Amamutsan Land Trust. The Land Trust is a 501c3 nonprofit organization established 2013 by the Amamutsan Tribal Band. The trust serves as a vehicle for the Amamutsan's return to land and practices of their ancestors. The Amamutsan are not a federally recognized tribe, meaning they don't own any land and don't receive any support from the government. These people were forcibly removed from their native lands over three waves of colonization. And there's about 800 Amamutsan tribal members still living mostly in the Central Valley. As I mentioned today, we have a special offering because the interim executive director, Sarah French, will be with us after the service to talk about the land trust, answer your questions, and to learn about what they are focusing on: conservation, restoration, education, and the revival of indigenous stewardship of the land we're now living on. Please stay online. And so, Sarah, if you wanted to just say a few words before we go into our next part of the service, I'll invite you to unmute yourself.
Thank you. You gave a really wonderful explanation for what we do. And I'm so grateful that all of the folks in this meeting are being exposed to this and learning about it. You know, the indigenous history of the lands that we live on is a history that's been purposefully kept from us. There's a lot that people don't know. And especially around this time of year, I think people are really asking questions and wanting to know more. And so I really am grateful for all of you for engaging in this journey of self-discovery, of finding this information and sharing it. And I'm really grateful to be with you here today to answer questions and talk a little bit more. I'm not a member of the tribe, but I've been working with the Amamutsan for over 10 years now. And I'm very inspired by how hard they are working to return to the land and the practices of their ancestors, to take care of their ancestral lands and to take care of their people and to take care of all beings, mm-hmm. really, that live in this place. So I'm really honored to be here and to speak with you all, and I can't wait to hear your questions. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And now, a particularly exciting time. During this time of Sunday services, many churches have introduced a virtual offering during the service. Today, we're doing that for the first time, and then we'll continue to do it every Sunday. In the next few minutes, we're going to introduce to you text giving. You will need your cell phone and your credit card, and we're going to try and do this with you together. Our treasurer, Ian Hunter, will walk you through the first time, one process of making the first virtual shared plate donation. If you don't manage it in the next few minutes, we're hosting a special breakout group where additional instructions will be provided. So if you can't walk along today and do it with your cell phone, with your smartphone, and your credit card, there will be coaching during upcoming services and this breakout group. So if you want to be in the breakout group, put text giving in the chat and Bryn will put you into that breakout group. And after you're done and learning, you can exit and return back to Sarah French talking with us. So Ian, I'm going to turn it over to you. If you would unmute yourself and tell us how we do this.
Thank you, Russ. Good morning, everybody. We're about to do something exciting. Russ, if you could give us the first screen picture showing that if Randy can do it, we all can do it. next picture, please, Russ. I must advise you that although I'll go through this tutorial quite slowly, some of you may not be able to make it to the end successfully. Do not despair. Your donation will not go through now, but this week we'll be sending out an email about information for how to do it described, And of course, Russ has mentioned the breakout session. After you have done what we're doing today or succeeded in registering, it'll be one simple text message every Sunday to make a donation in the future. So now, on your cell phone, tap the messaging icon, get to your messaging application. If your latest previous text message is still on the screen, sometimes you have to tap a back arrow until you have a start chat button. Or if you're on Android, it may be a circle with a pen. Or on iPhones, it's usually a square with a pen. So tap there to start a new message. On the to line, as you can see in the screen, type the phone number 855-700-7760. Some of you may still be trying to get to your number keypad, so I'll do that again. Have a number keypad and go 855-700-7760. Now in the text box, which is sometimes called the message box, type give space and a number without a dollar sign. That number is the amount of dollars you're going to donate today. For example, the Zoom screen shows how you type give 10. It could be a capital G or a small g. Could I have the next screen, please? And now you must tap the arrow that sends the message, usually a blue arrow at the top. Next screen, please, Russ. Since the system does not know your name or your credit card details, this message will come up. Complete your one-time registration with this link. Tap on the onechurch.page.link. Do that now. And after a few seconds, you'll get another screen that we'll work through together. Next screen, please, Russ. Okay, on this screen, ignore the login box and ignore the plus sign below shared. For today, everything donated will be shared, with half of it going to the Amman Mutsen Land Trust. The how often drop down, leave that as one time for now. Next week and in the future, we'll talk about other options here. Now we come to your payment options. You can use a credit card or a bank account. There are small transaction fees for using both. They're slightly lower for a bank account. So choose whether you're going to pay by debit card or bank account and tap that box. Next screen, please, Russ. We now enter the details asked for your credit card or bank account. Using the numeric keypad, enter the card number, or tap on the card number space and numeric keypad should come up. Enter your card number. Let's leave a few seconds for that. Following that, you will use the month dropdown to select the month of the expiry, and the year dropdown to select the year of the expiry. And then lastly on this section, your three-digit CVC security code. Now make sure that the save card info for faster donations next time is checked. You don't want to go through this but once. Next picture, please, slide. Please, Russ. As we go down the screen, you'll just have to scroll down, which you may have to. It's asking for the billing address to be entered. So let's leave a few seconds to do that. California appears on a drop-down. beneath this, there might be a continue button, which doesn't show on the screen. There should be a continue button. And then it would ask you for your name. If it doesn't know your name, I've got a text message to say go a little slower. So I'll repeat, you put in your address, street address, city, California, zip code, continue. Oh, it's the email address, which is not showing on the screen. The email address has to be entered. Then you continue. Now you should be on a screen that's asking for your first and last name. We're nearly there now. At the bottom of that screen, tap continue. And you get a screen which is something like we're looking at right now. So check that the no for giving on behalf of business is selected. And then check that enable by giving by text message is a yes. That's really important. Right near the bottom of the screen, it shows the option for you to add a few cents to cover the processing fees. It would be nice if you check that, because then the fellowship gets the full amount of your donation. Well, there we are. At the bottom, you have a blue box with give and an amount. And when you check, click on, or tap on that, we should be done. So check, tap on that, and I do hope some of you are still with me. On your screens now, you should see a blue reel rotating, and then you'll get a confirmation message. Oh, somebody has texted, has put in the chat box, it worked. Well done, Laura. Okay, to end off, I must advise you that soon you'll get a text message in your texting box. This screen that you entered things on can be discarded at this stage. You'll get a text message confirming your donation and requesting confirmation of your registration. Please respond to this text message with confirm and send, as it asks for. It'll ask you to confirm. Now, in conclusion, the next time you donate by text, you'll not need to go through this registration step again. It will be just give, a space, an amount, a space, and an optional keyword. Keywords will allow you to direct your payment to another fund, such as to your pledge account or to the birthday fund and others. The use of keywords will be explained fully in the communication this coming week and also at next Sunday service. As Russ mentioned, if you wish to join the breakout group, put text giving in your chat box. And that's all for me. I hope some of you succeeded. Thank you.
So just to repeat, if you just got frustrated just now, type text giving into the chat box and we'll put you with other people who are trying to learn how to do this. After your text giving tutorial, you can come back to the main session, the discussion with Sarah French, by clicking leave and return to main room. Do not click leave the whole meeting, but just leave the breakout group. And we will now begin to introduce Tom.
Thank you.
Now I'll invite Sylvia to unmute herself to give us our reading.
Spirit of the East, spirit of air, of morning and springtime, be with us as the sun rises. In times of beginning, times of planting, inspire us with a fresh breath of courage as we go forth into new adventures. Spirit of the South, spirit of fire, of noontime and summer, be with us through the heat of the day and help us to be ever growing. Warm us with strength and energy for the work that awaits us. Spirit of the West, spirit of water, of evening and autumn, be with us as the sun sets and help us to enjoy a rich harvest. Flow through us with a cooling, healing quietness and bring us peace. Spirit of the North, spirit of earth, of nighttime and winter, be with us in the darkness, in the time of gestation. Ground us in the wisdom of the changing seasons as we celebrate the spiraling journey of our lives. Joan Goodman.
And today, Sangye and myself will both do a sermon. I'll go first. And I invite you to put your screen on speaker view if you want to watch me. When I lived in Utah, we had zebra finches. Now, zebra finch is this little tiny bird that sings an incredible large amount, lives for about 2 years, and they're described as an ornamental bird because there's not much of a chance for establishing a relationship with them. You just watch and listen to them. And so I bought a used display cabinet, curio cabinet, took the top off, put wire in there and put in branches and set up a really pretty good cage for them. But if you've ever had finches, you know, as the pet store owner explained to me, they foul their nest. And I really didn't appreciate what that meant until you put, 10 birds into this large cabinet, what that means. You could clean that cage and it would stay clean for maybe a week or two. The glass, the floor, the water dish all had to be cleaned routinely. Now, I've often thought that as humans, we have a relationship with the land like my zebra finches. We foul our nest. And when someone cleans our cage, we enjoy the freshness, but then we foul it again. In my lifetime, I've seen us pull back from fouling our nest. I've seen how acting together, we can clean up our nest. The Clean Air Act of 1963 and 1970, the Air Quality Act of 1967, all of these were monumental in stopping and beginning to reverse the severe harm done in all the prior decades. The formation of the EPA, Environmental Protection Agency, in 1970 finally stopped the uncontrolled pollution by our factories and industries. Leaded gasoline began to be phased out in 1973 and was essentially gone by 96. From the 40s, 50s, and 60s, there was a plan to fill in large amounts of the San Francisco Bay. And in 1960s, that was a popular idea because of how polluted and toxic and smelly the bay had become. My own personal story is I traveled to Santa Monica, California from Utah very frequently in 1984 and 1985. And I will never forget going out for lunch, looking directly up at the sun at noon and barely able to see a little glow in the sky. It was bad, dangerous air for most of the year in Santa Monica. So in my lifetime, I've seen that we can change our impact on the earth with public outcry, public organizing, public pressures on politicians and legislatures, because of the unavoidable, undeniable pollution that was right in front of us. And I believe we succeeded because the consequences were so visible. We stopped fouling our nest. At least we slowed down the visible evidence of that anyway. But we have a culture, and our life is based on taking resources for our short-term benefit. Plastics, fossil fuels for our cars, our insatiable energy needs, water. The San Joaquin Valley is huge, middle of California, from Sacramento to Bakersfield, and due to agricultural pumping, the groundwater in some areas has dropped 28 feet. The water aquifers have dropped that much. But then in the 90s, we began to realize that we were beginning to foul our nest in non-visible ways. Oh, it's easy to agree on pollution when you can't see the sun. But when the consequences are not obvious or not right in front of our eyes, we can turn away. Today, we're not fouling our local nest, but humanity's nest. We didn't like seeing how fouled our nest were in the 70s and 80s, so we cleaned our nest. But we moved our poisons and excrements to other parts of the world, to places where the impact was invisible to us. We get lumber from foreign forests, from the Amazon rainforest. We dump our electronic and plastic waste in foreign countries where the dangers of handling them are shifted from us to marginalized people in far-off lands. We generate carbon emissions unrestricted, but we still have locally clean air, and we can keep our current lifestyle. We continue to view the land as a provider of resources for our taking. We continue to view the land as a place to dump our trash. We continue to see only our own nest, and all's well if my nest is clean. In my lifetime, the consequences of the way we foul our nest have gone from visible to invisible. But our fouled nest is becoming more and more visible. More visible in our country, in our land, and even in our county. Floods, hurricanes, and fires. Many of you were impacted by the fires of August and September. Our impacts are now visible. We're now seeing our own nest as fouled. Many years ago, I attended a Parliament of World Religions. 10,000 people gathered to listen to world religious leaders, to attend workshops. The theme of this gathering was reclaiming the heart of our humanity, working together for a world of compassion, peace, justice, and sustainability. Many keynote speakers from over 50 different faith traditions. One speaker I heard was from India. I will mispronounce his name, H.H. Punja Swami Shyanda. He's the president of one of India's largest and most renowned interfaith spiritual institutions. During his brief talk on climate change, he said something that pulled my eyes wide, wide open. He said, "The earth is not in trouble. The earth is not in danger or peril. The earth has been here for a long, long time. Humanity is in trouble. Humanity is in danger." Gratitude for the land is not about saving the land. This land, the earth, will be here long after we are gone. gratitude for the land is about our ability to survive. Survive by seeing the consequences we create and stopping them. But what can we do? What path is there so our children and their children will survive? Can we have two focuses in our life? Can we stop putting all our focus on the immediate issues of the pandemic and politics? Can we focus on the long view? Can we start having gratitude for the land? In my life, I have seen that we can clean our nest. It's time. It's time to begin again.
There are more rivers rising, this I know, this I know. There are more rivers rising, this I know. There are more rivers rising, they will find their way to us. There are more rivers rising, this I know. There are more fires burning, this I know, this I know. There are more fires burning, this I know. There are more fires burning, they will find their way to us. There are more fires burning, this I know. I will wade through the waters, this I know, this I know. We will wade through the waters, this I know. We will wade through the waters when they find their way to us. We will wade through the waters, this I know. We will walk through the fires, this I know, this I know. We will walk through the fires, this I know. We will walk through the fires when they find their way to us. We will walk through the fires when this I know.
Hi. I guess you're wondering where I am this time. Well, I'll give you a little clue. You see, I'm in a place that was affected by the LNU fire, the lightning complex fire that was happening same time as Santa Cruz. This was one of the larger fires, and it's in an area called Poudre Creek. And so you might want to ask, why am I out here? And we're going to be talking about the gratitude of the land, and that man in the background is my husband. We're about 15 minutes away from my house. And I came out here because, though there's so much char and so much destruction, there's actually a little bit of hope here, like that. And like this wonderful little gift. Now, I don't know if you can see the distance with my poor laptop camera, but I think you can pretty much see that that whole hillside was on fire. And this tiny little creek used to be almost all of this canyon. There's a dam up there that was put in the 1950s. So what's my point? What am I trying to say here? Land recovers, just like people. And we have to be grateful that this planet has the ability to recover and help it recover rather than contribute to its demise. Whenever we want to do something with gratitude, we often are thankful for all the gifts that are given to us. But how much do we give? And what is it that we do give? Robin Wall Kimmerer often talks about the cycle of reciprocity and how we need to take only what we need and give something back. So I'm asking you, what does that look like? Giving back can be fraught with difficulty. We feel resentful, or we feel put upon, or we feel like it's not fair. What did they do for me? Or nobody ever cared about me. Why should I help anybody? How do I do this? They won't like what I do. There's so many different kinds of things that we go through when we think about gratitude. What we don't think about is how important it is to be in balance with giving. And to understand that when you give, you're giving not just of yourself, but for the greater long-term good. Climate change is the result of a collaborative taking. We know this. So it makes me wonder, what does collaborative giving look like? One individual can do a great deal of harm, as we've seen, and one corporation can do a great deal of harm. So I ask you again, what does a single organization do? In the next few months, you're going to be thinking about that a lot. What can the fellowship do to collectively change the world, or give back, or a combination? Is changing the world giving back? It's kind of a different way to look at the things around us. But when we understand that the cycle of life from burning to renewal comes along, some really amazing things can happen. Life does come back no matter how much we try to destroy it. And I don't know if you can see down there, but there's an egret. That tiny, tiny little white speck down there. And often you've heard the idea that, well, I tried to get something done and it didn't work out, and I tried really hard. Lord knows I know what that's about, and I'm sure you guys have all seen my attempts at trying to do things. And, you know, it doesn't work out because we're not doing it from a place of generosity or gratitude. We're doing it from a place of, I want to look good. And so we have to step back and we have to say, what's needed here? Not what do I need or what do we need as an organization, but what is needed here? And I try really hard sometimes, fail miserably all the time, but I try really hard sometimes to figure out what it means to do the right thing. And when things don't go right, I step back and say, well, was my motivation right? In Buddhism, we have a little thought about that. Motivation drives all actions, and therefore is kind of influences the outcome. That dam up there was built to water agricultural businesses that were growing in this area. And what they ended up finding out was that they actually depleted the groundwater down here. So it didn't help at all. And now they're left with a tiny, tiny creek. No salmon, no lifestyle, no livestock, nothing here. They're left with a dry, desiccated place that torches instantly. So I ask you again, what does the world need from us right now? What do our fellow members in this church need from us right now? What are the things that this virus has given us that we can use right now? Well, this virus gave me this internship, which is helping me in ways I never thought possible. All of you have given me your time, your treasure, and your talent so that I can go on and work with the greater world in a capacity of a minister. You did this, not me. I'm just showing up and trying to figure things out. What you're doing as an institution, what your core values are as a group of people who've come together, influences and changes what will collectively happen for the good. We have some great things that have already happened when we saw collectivity and positivity. But sometimes the landscape gets scorched. And sometimes it's going to be hard to replenish this landscape and bring it back to life. But again, look at the green banks and the egret down there, and the birds singing, and a whole lot of life coming back. That's what we have to do. Let's take the long view, and let's hope. Keep our hopes up. COVID is giving us a chance to incubate and think about the future. There is a future, even though it might feel like this. There is a future, and it's running and alive down there. Ashe, and blessed be, and have gratitude for the land.
I'm going to move on to joys and sorrows. A community supports itself. We hold each other. We share our joys and our concerns in solidarity together, knowing that our story is not alone in its sorrows or in joys. If you have something on your heart, a joy, a sorrow that you would like to share with this community, this safe community, I invite you to activate the chat option. Put in your joy or sorrow, and Sangye and I will do our best to read them.
I think Lorraine is asking for a memory of someone named Dick. I don't know if it's a joy or a sorrow.
I don't.
And I'm having a little trouble with my internet connection, so.
As am I.
Yeah.
Edie Rhodes says, joy for being able to see my family in Portland, Oregon before the state closed. I have a wonderful new grandnephew being with me brought me so much joy.
From Heather, she says, I want to express my thanks to this community. You have become a very important part of my life and you enrich my life so greatly. Blessings to you all. And to you, Heather.
Ian Hunter writes, the Genty Hunter is pleased to tell us all that Dick Cortum is home after his surgery and is doing well. Glad to hear it.
Zion Tunstall writes, joy. I am infinitely blessed and grateful to have stable housing once again after the fires, to be able to live in a home that nourishes me, that provides me space and healing, and to be surrounded by nature. Amen.
Gail Swain says, sad that Thanksgiving this year and likely Christmas too will be very small with just the people on our property.
Erica Crawford writes, I am grateful to have a two-week escape to Costa Rica, visiting John, David, and Jermaine, and return healthy.
Sierra says, my younger brother tested positive for COVID. So far, he says he only has mild cold symptoms.
Oh, blessing. Tara Collier Young writes, I have a sorrow that my sister does not understand why Scott and I are not coming to her home for Thanksgiving when she has invited many people who are not in my COVID coven.
Fred Simone says, sorrow for the increase in COVID-19 nationwide. Hopefully it will be dealt with effectively by the Biden administration.
Suri writes, thank you to Reverend Russ and I for the focus on climate change. Thank you, Suri, for listening so well.
Bill Welch says, I'm grateful that my friend Bruce is in a safe place in the hospital.
Zion writes that we pronounced their name correctly. Joy, people often get it wrong. Not a big deal, but small things are just as important as the big. And I totally relate with that being the name that I have.
Renata McCree says, I am grateful that despite these tough times, my sister and her husband were finally able to move back to California, which they have been trying to do for at least 3 years. Welcome home.
Child religious educator Tara is grateful for all the sweet faces on RE service this morning. Yes, indeed.
Peggy Lee says, thank you to my own ancestors for their sacrifices and to the ancestors of this native land. May we all heal together.
We are and continue to do so. I will give another few seconds to wait. Thank you all for sharing the deepness of your hearts. And I would like to take a moment for all of us to hold within our own bodies the joys and the sorrows, the gratitude and the grief in the immense space that is our collective heart. Let us meditate for just a moment on these deeply important and profound things.
and critics who prophesize with your pen, and keep your eyes wide, the chance won't come again. And don't speak too soon, for the wheel's still in spin, and there's no telling who that it's naming, for the loser now will be later to win, for the times they are a changing.
Come senators, congressmen, please heed the call, don't stand in the doorways, don't block up the hall, for those who get hurt will be those who have stalled. There's a battle outside and it's raging, it'll soon shake your windows and rattle your walls, for the times they are a-changing.
Come mothers and fathers throughout the land, and don't criticize what you can't understand. Your daughters are beyond your command, your old road is rapidly aging. Please get out of the new one if you can't lend your hand, for the times they are a-changing.
The lion is drawn, the curse is cast, the slow one now will later be fast, as the present
time for us to end our service, and we will do so with the poem Remember by Native American poet Joy Haru. Remember the sky that you were born under. Know each of the stars' stories. Remember the moon. Know who she is.
Remember the sun's birth at dawn. That is the strongest point of time. Remember sundown and the giving away to night.
Remember your birth, how your mother struggled to give you form and breath. You are the evidence of her life, her mother's and hers.
Remember your father, he is your life also. Remember the earth whose skin you are, red earth, black earth, yellow earth, white earth, brown earth, we are earth.
Remember the plants, trees, animal life, who all have their tribes, their families, their histories too. Talk to them, listen to them. They are alive poems.
Remember the wind, remember her voice. She knows the origin of this universe. Remember, you are all people, and all people are you.
Remember you are this universe and the universe is you. Remember all is emotion, is growing, is you.
Remember language comes from this. Remember the dance language is. That is life.
Remember.
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 Remember. I invite you to virtually connect with someone that you care about and reach out and touch their hand through the distance between us. We're still connected.
Thank you.
I wish for all of you is that you have a good holiday season and do the best you possibly can. I invite you now to unmute yourself. Go on gallery view and give a shout out for what you're feeling on your heart at this moment.
Thank you, Sangye. Oh, I am grateful.
That was really profound.
That was lovely. Hope.
Beautiful that's service. Beautiful service.
Beautiful service. Beautiful service.
For the community. Oh. Very nice.
Beautiful for the community.
Thank you to all the musicians who worked so hard today, the singers, the musicians, and our lovely musical director and our lovely pianist.
Thank you, everybody.